Grand Tron and Taurus. So we're gonna be basically building our stability, changing things up, and of course building a new persona, because we're gonna be experiencing some changes when it comes to where we have, wherever we have Taurus at in our charts. So now we got the Moon square in Saturn. So learn how to be emotionally mature, because of course mommy ain't gonna be there to suck on that. We ain't gonna always be there to suck on mommy titties. Also, we got the Venus opposing Chiron, feeling disconnected when it comes to relationships and commitments. We're gonna be feeling that shit right now. We're gonna be feeling disconnected by individuals, or the media can make you feel disconnected. We also got the Sun Tron Moon. This is basically having the gift to react and respond, to be out there and be stabilized. We also got the Moon conjuncting Uranus. This is feeling passionate about change. You're gonna be feeling strong about change, whether you changing the situation or being open for new opportunities. So you're gonna feel change in some way when it comes to this moon, because the moon is also exalted here too. So we also gonna have Mercury Tron Pluto. This is thinking deep about reality. So we're gonna be out here really thinking deep about reality, seeing the ways that you can transform shit out your mind, because your mind creates your reality. So think deep about how you trying to create your reality, and not think deep about the bullshit the media giving you. Also, we got the Mars Trine Uranus. This is having the gift to have your own passion in your own way. You got to have your own passions in this world. You got to work with the energies, cope with the energies. The universe can work with you. Also, we got the Mars opposed Neptune. This is feeling disconnected with our dreams. We could be passionate about certain things, but of course, we could be feeling disconnected when it comes to our dreams and shit. So it's going to be some ways where we may not even want to basically go with the mundane. So the Mars can be having you feel disconnected right now with your passions, because Mars is in Virgo, which is opposite Neptune. So the way we sometimes when we get stereotyped, sometimes when we get on our dreams, sometimes when we basically rebel. So that's how it plays out. Also, we got the Saturn sextile Chiron, opportunities to basically make mistakes, but basically build structure around these areas. So you're gonna be making mistakes, but building structure. Neptune sextile Pluto. This is basically having the power and opportunities to basically take full deep control over your reality in a dream. Because sometimes you may be in a dream, sometimes you may have to come out of reality. Take full power control over your dreams. Also, we're gonna have Sun opposing Jupiter. This is seeing disconnections when it comes to experiences. So we're gonna be basically, could be very impulsive, very optimistic. Try not to do too much of that. Also, got the Sun Trine Uranus, the gift to be yourself and be myself. Be yourself, for me. You need to be yourself right now, for me. Can't be catering to these fake ass ideas and fake ass programs that they put you in. Be yourself, and you'll work well with these energies. We also got the Moon Trine Mars. This is feeling passionate about your goals, or feeling passionate about work routines. Also, you ever got the Mercury opposing Neptune. So this is thinking hard about illusions, feeling very indecisive with your thoughts. You could be feeling disconnected with your mind. We also got Venus trine Saturn, the gift to be emotional mature when it comes to love. We also got Mars trine Pluto, the gift to feel deep about determination and passion, whatever you're trying to strive for. So this is good energy to basically use and accumulate when you're going. Wherever you have Taurus at in your house, these are the areas where you need to find a new way to build. So of course, when it comes to Taurus in the first house, this is building a new persona when it comes to your personality. Some people, places, things may be acting funny towards you during this time. Some people may be switching up when it comes to your personality and personal fears, or you may be switching up. Taurus in a second house, this is building a new value system. So pretty much, this is a situation where you need to start valuing yourself and not valuing other shit that don't mean shit to you. Also, if you got Taurus in the third house, you're going to be valuing building a new home, building a new environment right now, feel me? You may put yourself into a position of basically being Forrest Gump, wanting to join the military, getting out of a situation where you want to get out of your environment and do something better. Other people may basically look at your environment very boring or dull. Don't fuck these motherfuckers. Build your own environment. This is how you see the world. Taurus in the fourth house, building a new home. You could be feeling bored in your home, or it could be some ups and downs in your home, or it could be situations where individuals may not appreciate or respect you in your home, but of course your ancestors do, so be aware. Also, if you got Taurus in the fifth house, you're going to be building a new hobby. Feel me? You might be very spiritual, very religious, or of course you may put yourself into a new position of being very creative in these areas. You could be fucking a Jesus Christ in this possession. Build your creativity. Have faith. Also, if you got this in the sixth house, you're going to be building a new routine and shit, feel me? You're going to have some problems here too, feel me? You may be in a situation where you may be overindulging, or you may put yourself into a position of having adultery going on, marrying other people's issues when it comes to routines. Try not to do that. Got this in the seventh house. You're going to be building a new relationship. You could be very jealous, very envious about certain individuals or certain partnerships. You can be very gossiping and shit. Try not to put yourself into that position. Watch out for these things, because it's going to put you in a setback situation. Because remember, you can overindulge into these areas, feel me? So try not to do that. Also, If you have this in the 8th house, this is going to be some crazy shit going on right here. Building new desires. You may put yourself into a position of looking for Debo, because you might as well take your goddamn bike. Debo took your bike. You may have issues with motherfuckers maybe looking for you. Where my money at? Be very careful with money right now. If you got that here. And it's in the 9th house, you're going to be building new experiences. Feel me? You could be very lucky in this position. You may be able to sue somebody or get money and shit. Be aware. You got this in your 10th house. You'll be building a new career, new status, and new goals and shit. Feel me? Try not to allow yourself to put yourself into a position of feeling guilty about these things. You have this in the 11th house. You could be building new associates. You may overindulge into associates, the public and shit. You may be going to the extremes and shit. Overindulging when it comes to money and possessions. Try not to go to the extremes in these areas. You'll be right. If you have this in your 12th house, you'll be building a new fantasy, a new dreams, a new desires. You may be dreaming a lot, imagining a lot, of course.